Good shot. There we go. Early 10. She's got a silver medal from the World Junior Championship in women's double that was back in 2018. Lost to Liu Shanshan and Xie Yuqing from China. She's also making their way on the World Tour at the moment, the two Chinese players. That's a great rally. Just missed it there. Now there's a challenge. I don't think they noticed the call from the linesman. And it wasn't out either, it was in actually. That's why they really didn't pay a lot of attention, because they thought that that was, of course, a good shot. Fantastic attack from the Malaysians, but to follow a little bit up on the story with Chihara Shida, who rolled her ankle yesterday. She's not selected for the team today in the match between Japan and Chinese Taipei. It's former Olympic women's doubles champion Misaki Matsutomo with double world champion Ayo Matsumoto, so a scratch pairing from Japan. Missed it. But that's something that I expected them to display, Tan and Tina. I had the pleasure of watching them win their first Super 300 tournament in Swiss Open earlier on this year, defeating Stephanie and Gabriela Stoyeva convincingly in the final. And I thought, wow, what an attacking pair, fast on their feet as well. So definitely think we're going to hear more of these two players on the World Tour. So I was a little surprised to see that they lost against England, and also perhaps not so surprised yesterday against Shida and Matsuyama, the former World Junior Champions. But given that Shida rolled her ankle, I thought maybe they would have a chance to win that match. But impressive that Shida got into her shoes again and ended up winning the match. Hopefully it's not too seriously the ankle injury. I like that little flick of the racket there, keeping it steep. Is Tina jump smash from Polii Tan. They're playing for a medal now. If Tina and Tan can win this match, and they're in the semi-final. congratulations for Rahayu and Polii. Basically this tournament probably comes a little bit too early, but I don't know if they had enough time to enjoy the Olympic gold medal yet. They played well in the first two matches, and I guess from an Indonesian perspective, this is the tournament where they are required to shine more than the Uber Cup. I'm not saying that Uber Cup is unimportant, I'm just saying that I feel Indonesia has a bigger chance in this tournament than perhaps in the Uber Cup. I don't think the women's singles are strong enough yet. Of course they have a good depth, but difficult to threaten in the Uber Cup. This time a challenge? No, it wasn't. Croatia a challenge. Yeah. Different kind of shirts. It's the umpire. Is it the line again? Wow! The narrowest of margins. And Rahayu looks puzzled. What's going on here? Am I on candid camera or what? But I actually think it was much closer than the Indonesian thought. Forehand serve. Yeah, that's well played. Jump smash again from Politan, and it's efficient when she comes to the mid-court area. Then it really gives her some extra angle. Perception that, at least in Denmark, that our female players, they couldn't jump smash. That's of course rubbish. Of course they can jump. It's obviously probably doesn't jump as high as, well, they don't jump as high as men, but they can still gain an angle advantage. It's also something to do with your shot technique. We also see Rahayu do jump smash. She's flying around from left to right and hitting those smashes. So it's an integrated part of the game for some players now. After a new racket. It's gone long, according to the line judge, and Rahayu challenges that call. She's seen that there's points in it when the Malaysians are doing it. I'm not sure she's right here. No, that was indeed long.
One challenge remaining. Service over. 9-6.
A little laugh from Rahayu there.
Service from Cole, too high. Service over.
Service from Cole, too high. Service judge, Kai Utu. From the home nation, Finland.
Thank you.
match power. I don't think Grisha Polii had that before the lockdown. So I think the lockdown period has sort of helped her recover a bit physically. And that's helped their women's double combination. Fantastic rally. Oi! Two dives. Oh, and in the end, it's the Olympic champions who prevails. They're really giving it all. Almost diving both of them after that one. Really some entertaining pairs in women's double at the moment. This pair here, the Malaysian up-and-coming pair, is a joy to watch. Number 19 on the world ranking right now. We have Matsuyama and Shida, the Japanese pair. They played yesterday, the World Junior Champions. They're also a pair that plays fast and furious. A couple of the young Indonesians, Rita Sugiyato and Amaranti, in one of the group stage matches, they played interesting women's doubles as well. There's numerous other pairs, but it's really entertaining to watch at the moment. And also saw that in the Olympics. Good defense. Good flat game. Oi. A little bit carried away there, Polutan, and it's Polii and Rahayu who is up here at the mid-game interval.
Indonesia!
Impression and the shadow is up in the net, so unusual advantage. Polii was celebrating a little bit too early.
Service over. 16-12.
Been a little bit too eager, in my opinion, Thinaah and Tan here. Not easily, but they can withstand the attack, so they could play a clear or a lock once in a while. Close one to the top of the tape. And it's a good rally.
13-16.
They should trust their own defense a little bit more. And it's a win this shot there from that Polii time. So any mistakes may be extra costly.
Challenges
again. If they get this right as well, I think Rahayu will believe that they're playing against Chimalaysians and Hawkeye, but that's not the case this time on the line. And there are no challenges, as Stefan Minnet tells us. Oi, good save. You saw how Thinaah had to adjust. Ooh, plays too sharp. I wonder when they review this first game and watch it on video, how many mistakes and how many points they created for the Indonesians, how many points the Polii created for their opponents that were unnecessary, but the choices are not correct. This is played with too much greed. That's a good counter-attacking shot from Thinaah there. Ability, attack and power, and find the right mix of patience and attack. Still two game points for Polii and Rahayu. Excellent drives from the Olympic champions there. That's a great rally played by Thinaah and Polii Tan, and now just 1 point in it. Built it patiently there, good follow up. Two women standing side by side at the net, certain that there's so much pressure on their shots that Grisha Polii is not able to get it past them. It's coming right. Ooh. Took no chance there. Behind. I can understand it. That's fantastic play. Really, really well played by the two Malaysians. Patient build up and then going for the outer side. Luke Politan is going all the way out there to cover that one.
Stop walking around the court. Take your place, serve or receive. Okay.
Yeah, still coming in. Doesn't want him to waste time. Oh, that comes over as well. And dive. And then Rahayu finally puts it away. So, after surviving 5 game points, Thinaah has to survive yet another one.
Thank you. Players on board.
And then we have the dive there. No length on it, then easy kill for Rahayu. Ah, she's not satisfied with it, and you could have supported us a bit more, she says. Something like that. It's gone. Poli Tan's racket is gone. Yeah. Now there's problems. Challenge. It wasn't gone, the racket.
No challenge remaining.
No, she can't challenge. It's a game. They have no challenges remaining. And that means the first game to Polii and Rahayu. After just under half an hour in play, 22-20. What an entertaining first game that was. It looked to be clearly wide, but that's why you should economize a little bit with your challenges.
Second game underway.
guys don't do.
Service over. One, no.
Played each other in the next Thailand Open in January. Had to get his 2-0 in Polii in Ohio. Obviously won that match, and not only did they win the match, they also won the tournament, which was significant in my opinion, first Super Thousand tournament for the two Indonesians, but also the tournament where I really noticed Tam and Tina reached the semi-final, no, the quarter-final, big opponent of the Yonex Thai Open. Lost to Polii in Ohio there, but on the way beat Chiyanah and Kim Hae-rin from Korea, the strong Korean pair. And then another quarter-final towards the Thai Open, losing to compatriots Cho Mae-kwon and Lee Min-hyun. Cho retired. Oh, yes. Great awareness by Tina Muralitharan to play the cross net shot there. She knows that Polii is not going back to the other side for that one, so it will draw Rahayu all the way up to the net. Satisfied there, thumbs up.
Time.
24 shots. Not rally here. I could easily foresee that we could see some even longer rallies if Tan and Tina have decided to play a little bit more patiently. Not so much reps. Opportunity to get help from the drift if the angle is right. If the angle is too flat, then the drift is working against them in terms of taking it out on the back line.
Thank you.
Polii, what a shot. Fantastic shot from Grace Polii. Moving in run direction with a 90 degree angle to the net and hitting it in another direction. Wow! And then Rahayu flying in to put it away. You cannot fault them for not giving everything, that's one thing that's sure. Player. It seems like Polii and Rahayu, they're playing with this sort of attitude that everybody's seeking, that this is fun and we're enjoying ourselves, and wow, maybe I can make that shot. Oh no, I couldn't, but I think maybe I can next time. And sort of like just enjoying it, that this Olympic gold medal has sort of basically done everything it should for their careers. Everything that comes from now on is just a bonus as we get the doctor on hope for a, suppose it's a scratch or a blood injury. Enjoy playing, looking around, thinking we're fortunate that we are doing what we love. And remember, the now president of the BWF choir said that that's a bit of a chance to say that the last team BWF is going to be ever overshadowed in terms of badminton. Is it now? It's always going to be with you. But at least you got that one tournament right. It's so difficult to win. Yeah. I'm a little bit in doubt, Peter, and that's exactly the decisions that Polii and Rahayu are now sort of feeding off the. Difficult decisions from the Malaysian pair that's going on. That's what I felt was so much better with the two Indonesians in the Olympics, especially with Rahayu, who was the junior part of this women's double, and she played a lot of good badminton, but sometimes decision making lacked a little bit. It was not at all the case in the Olympics.
Nine.
first break points to put in Rahayu and four consecutive to Thinaah.
Apriani, get ready.
Legs. Beat in that half-court challenge, Gracia Polii, but what a fantastic effort there from Pearly Tan. Polii just, she's just ready for the next rally, and Tan is sort of like breathing heavily, it seems, from here. Very good smash. And six consecutive points for the Malaysians. Points that probably had at 9-5 is gone. We'll have the Malaysians with them for the long haul now.
11-10 in total.
Right, that one, and a 1-point lead for the Olympic champions as we head to the weekend interval here in the second game. Deciding match in this overall tie here, or Thinaah force a deciding game in this match, perhaps create the sensation against the Olympic champions.
11-4. 12-11.
Excellent technical skills with both the Malaysian players here. Now 3 points after the interval gone to Thinaah. 8 out of the last 10. Great block there. 12-13. Oh, that's a pity. That's amazing women's double. It's really, really entertaining. But the Indonesians, they have a solid defense and a little bit of luck.
16-13.
Taking the pace off, putting it well below the tape. Should avoid getting into that, the two Malaysians, because I think in the long run, the Indonesians have the advantage there. Try to push pressure every time, but it's still a little bit awkward. Easy for the Indonesians. Another good disguised drop shot from Polii Tan, and Polii and Rahayu, they have a little bit of trouble at the moment scoring in the regular attack versus defense game. Yeah, that's where they can score. They started on the third shot.
15-17. Grecia. Grecia. Don't go to the court to the end of back of the court. Get ready to serve.
Challenge from the Indonesians.
Challenge and successful. One challenge remaining. Service over. 18-15. Service over. 16-18.
Experience in these kind of situations. Looking at court. No defense there. It's gone long.
Service over. 19-16.
Shots in that rally.
Thinaah.
Fucking battle. Yeah, they're delighted with their own effort. They should be.
Service over. 17-19.
Let's do this. Dangerous for Malaysians to be lured into the flat game exchanges. I think Paul in Ohio has more awareness in the long run.
Service over.
That's aggressive play. I like it. I like the attack of Paul's service. 17. Not everybody who has the means to do it. But I mean the size and the movement to challenge on the short while still covering the long serve, but now three game points for the Malaysians. Lucky was the Polish. She stood, but there it is. First time of asking. Tan and Tina forced a decider against the Olympic champions, winning the second game here. 21-17 from 9-5, they totally took over control. And yeah, I'm looking really forward to see the decider here in this women's double. Overall in tie, 2-1 for Malaysia, so a win here would see them through to the semi-final. Polii and Rahayu must win to get their mixed doubles players on court for a final match. Exciting. And Rahayu playing to keep the tie alive, and Tan and Tina playing to secure Malaysia at least a bronze medal here at the World Team Championship. From both Tan and Tina. Good defense. Oh, she got up. Oh, fantastic. Excellent put away by Apriani Rahayu. Looked a little bit out of control, but point is a point. Try to get into the flat game, the complicated exchanges.
Serve, serve.
Not the playing offense, defense game. Before serving, she was shaking her right arm. Signs of what we in Denmark directly translated called the iron glove. And you get a little bit nervous and not that losing your arm anymore.
It's
so spray,
you can start spraying
the
number. No spray,
you're already on one.
That
spray
did you
have?
That's
good.
No spray.
I don't know. Paid enough attention. I didn't see the situation where she met the spray. Oh, that hurt. Mentioning and the normal procedure is that you can get sprayed, but not on the same body part. That's something that's decided in the team manager's meeting.
6-3.
To get out of that one, Tan and Tina, the Indonesians had tracked them, dared them to play creative shots, ready to cover it, but they still managed to get out of it. On this near side of the court, the Malaysians. Defense of Rahayu, really, really good. And, the Malaysians are smashing up against the drift. All right. Beautiful play. Experience.
7-4.
In full display. And then Rahayu, who is all too young. And then singles player who played against Egypt. Still play with lots of variation, not get into some of these set situations where Polii is stationary at one corner. Patience. We'll be unclear about the plan when the rally gets past these 25 shots. Excellent play. Magnificent play by the Olympic champions here in the first part of the third game, really using all of their experience against the youngsters from Malaysia, Tan and Tina. It's the defense that does the trick, that one. And we can finish it off. 11-5 here at the mid-game interval. Thank you.
20 seconds. 20 seconds. Coach, return to your chair.
So advantage Indonesia, 11-5 here in the decider. Are really living the match. Seeing a lot of action, Thinaah, at the moment. Magnificent rally, excellent women's double here in Energy Arena. What a rally to stop the second part of the third game with. And let me just remind you that this is played in slow playing conditions. Amazing rally here with attacks and patient play.
Ladies, can you come please, all four. During the rally, stop going up and down the road. Stay on the court ready to play or proceed.
Thank you. So he's just awarded 5-10 seconds of extra break to the players as Stéphane Renet. And playing the far side of the court, the Malaysians attack has a bigger chance of succeeding. Play the near side here, and it's up against the drift.
Third serve. 12-6.
It's never going to be a winner. It's never going to be a winner. So it hurts really a lot to making mistakes, especially when you're 5 points behind in the decider. Particularly half sideline there. Priyani Rahayu.
Thank you.
play, then the Malaysians can take a step, at least a half step forward, because the Indonesians are having difficulties killing it using power, so they're going to have to be creative on the front court. If they play the back court, they just clear back. Very difficult for Polii and Rahayu to kill it if they lift this line off. This was not the case here. If you see the replay, you can see Rahayu in his mid-court area, so... I'm willing to give Rahayu that. I also think it's time for the Indonesians to no longer take any chances. No 3 points, because 3 points is still a good lead, but closer than that, the morale really goes up with Thinaah. Oi, oi, oi.
Service over.
90. Hit that smash there. Well, still a relatively new player. Started the partnership in 2019 at the Malaysia International Series and won that tournament. Good to go because Tom's regular partner underwent no surgery. Chance. She was attacking in the defense, so to speak, or at least playing offensive defense. Rahayu, look how close to the net she stands, so she can play the flat return. That was a brilliant idea. She's missed it, yeah. A little deception, and then it got too long after all, and using a challenge on it. At least they get a little break, but we saw in the first game how much they needed an extra challenge. Wanted to challenge the match, the game point, but not many more challenges left.
Successful. One challenge remaining. Service over, 16-11. Red.
Excellent. I think it was the idea that Rahayu was going to return that, but fantastic save by Polii. And again, cross and the cross player proves really valuable. So, I think the next double players have started warming up now. Defense by Thinaah there. First cross and cross, total cross and cross from the player standing on cross from the one side, and then the same thing from the next side. Really bad explanation, I realize that. But very efficient from Polii and Rahayu. Of play here, and if you think that it's a long match, then I can tell you it's just about half of the longest match ever, which also featured Gracia Polii. Lasted 2 hours and 40 minutes.
Service over. 12-19. Yes, Lander's missing.
Opportunities for Polii and Rahayu. Eight chances to level the score in the overall tie. The shot to try and change it went wide. Opposite side of the court. Really annoying for the players. Oh, it's too high. He's quite satisfied there. Polii 10 survived. Another match point. Gone now.
16-20.
Four left. Still a tough task. I survived. Five game points in the first game. Turning 19 only to lose on the sixth.
Thank you. There's the fourth. Abriani.
Fantastic save, and then an immediate counterattack.
17-20.
Almost unbelievable, isn't it? Can't really believe that they can survive eight match points against the Olympic gold medalists. Also become a little bit more tense themselves. Malaysia is the closer they get. Wide.
18-20.
Six match points survived now. Two left. So Polii is tired, but delighted. The Malaysians are disappointed. But what a match they gave us. What a women's double. Amazing entertainment. Exactly 1.5 hours of play.
Match won by Indonesia.
And once again, Polii and Rahayu have delivered. They were stretched all the way by a fantastic playing young combination from Malaysia, but in the end, experience prevailed. And I think Polii looked a little bit injured there in the end, but she looked a little bit tired at least. Here is the final rally. They've leveled the score, the Indonesians 2-2. They're devastated, but yeah, surviving six match points. What's she saying? Why do we always have to do it the hard way or something? Perhaps they're going to play again tomorrow. That's what they're hoping for, both of these two pairs. And it's going to be decided in a little while. Here is confirmation of the score, 22-20, 21-17. And on the seventh match point, 21-18 in 1 hour and 30 minutes.